welcome. It's Kylie Bertucci, Stamping Up Demonstrator in Australia, here with you. And we are doing a premiere today, so it is not exactly live, but kind of live, because more than likely I will be in the chat and saying hello to you all. So big thank you to all our regulars. We love you all very, very much. Thank you for being here, and I know we'll see lots of those amazing names that we usually see pop up, like Charlotte. And there's always someone amazing popping up who's helping me out. Caitlin, and who else have we got? Linda, Karen. There's always amazing, amazing followers, and we really appreciate you all. I do want to give a bit of a shout out though to all of our amazing YouTube VIPs. These people have signed up for our membership and they get a few behind the scenes exclusives. Even photos of me doing my Pilates and different places that Brianna and I have got to go to have some yummy food and just lots of fun things that I do behind the scenes, cooking and all different things. So you're welcome to join up either for the creative membership or the demonstrator training membership. And we've got some awesome, awesome content coming in the next month or two. So definitely, definitely going to want to check it out. You can do just like 1 month and then you can cancel. So just check it out and you'll get access to everything. So there's even like tutorials and all sorts of amazing things. And we've got some really cool, I've got this little cowlick of a piece of hair here who wants to go in my mouth. Go away from my mouth, little cowlick. I love it, cowlick. So, what are we going to do today? Well, firstly, did someone say Beveragino? Grab your Beveragino. Get something from the cabinet. Maybe you want, you know, an alcoholic beverage if you're in the evening somewhere. Or if you're here in Australia, maybe a cup of coffee or a cup of tea. Totally up to you. I won't judge you. It's 5 o'clock somewhere in the world. So that will be very nice. And please, before we start, big, big, big shout out to everyone in Florida with Hurricane Milton. From the time that I'm recording this, it's actually Wednesday evening here in Australia. And I know that it's going to be landing Thursday morning for all. Actually, it will be probably coming up pretty soon to landing. We know that Lisa and Gina and her family are caught right in the thick of all of it. And we've been praying for them continually, and all our other fellow Stampin' Up! Friends. Please know that we're keeping you in our prayers and we're thinking of you. And please let us know once it all passes what we can do to support you and help out, because it's pretty stressful over there at the moment. So please know that we're thinking of you and hope that everything is a-okay for you all. Big hugs. It's very scary. I've been following it and I'm like, oh my goodness, my brain can't even comprehend what having a hurricane is like. We have fires and floods in Australia and we've never had to evacuate. We came close one time and yeah, it was pretty full on, but nothing like what these guys are experiencing at the moment. So we really have a lot of empathy for all of you and we're sending our love to you all. So what we're going to do today, I am actually going to be showing you our customer cards for the month, because it's a lot of fun to make our customers a beautiful card to say thank you for your order. So if you place an order with us in Australia, we're showing you what you're going to receive this month. So if you'd like a Kylie Bruno card, then this is a good time to place an order. And we're going to be using this gorgeous suite here, which is the Splendid Autumn. And I like to use the same suite as the tutorial bundle of the month. So if you haven't seen our tutorial bundle for the month, this is it here. It's absolutely stunning. It's Splendid Autumn. And if you purchase from us, not only will you get the customer card with this suite, but you will also get this tutorial bundle of 12 classes for free. I know, 12 classes for free from 12 amazing designers from all around the world. And that's just, and there's no minimum order. So what are you waiting for? If you live in Australia, scan that QR code if you want to purchase it. You can purchase it. So that's for those of you that can't place an order. But if you live in Australia, you can just go to our website, kyliebertucci.com, and go shopping from there. So who doesn't want a free tutorial? Get $22 tutorial. Freebies! Yes, please! I love a freebie. So let's have a look at the card. Look at this. Isn't that stunning? I just absolutely adore this paper. I'm like completely and utterly hooked. And there's quite a few papers that will be perfect for this type of card. You know, you've got your laneway here, you've got a beautiful pathway here, even this sunset. There's so many beautiful papers in here that is just going to look absolutely spectacular with this one, even this one here. Today we're going to be using this scenic one here. I really like the look of that one. So I think it'll be nice to sort of frame that tree and that pathway, and we'll have that as our card today. And so of course the colors I'm just changing up a little bit to match the paper. And it's just brilliant that Stampin' Up! Have everything here for us to know what colors to use. You know, they've got the Moody Mauve and the Cherry Cobbler and the Cajun Craze, Wild Wheat, Mossy Meadow. So it's just really nice to have all of the color choices that are already picked out for you. I've decided to go with Highland Heather and this beautiful, beautiful pink, which I'm going to butcher the name because I always do, Bubble Bath. I was about to say Bubblegum Pink. I don't know why, but we're doing Bubble Bath. Now, I have not chopped into my paper because I want to do some chopping with you today. And I'm going to show you how my card template tutorial is just the best thing you can get. If you haven't got this tutorial in your life, you need it. It's just the best way to make sure that you're chopping your cardstock the best way possible to get the most out of your cardstock. If you live in, anywhere in the world, you should be able to get one of these pieces of paper and cut it in half either widthways or lengthways, and that will be a card. So you can see here, let me show you what I mean. So you can see here, this is the Calypso Coral size. So you can see here, it's just one half of this paper. If you can't chop this in half and get two card bases, you're chopping it wrong in your country, because you must be following measurements from another country. Here in Australia, you should be able to chop in half and get two card bases, either lengthways or widthways. So let's have a look at widthways. That's it, widthways. So you can see here, if you chop this in half, you will get two card bases. So no wastage from one sheet, two card bases, awesome. You don't want to waste your cardstock. You want to get the most out of it. So we're going to do, I'm going to do it lengthways, but most people like to do the gorgeous grape layer, which means it's like sort of your regular sort of card. Like most people open a card like this, but I really like the Calypso Coral layer because of how it photographs. It photographs really well. And it's just something a little bit different, but you don't have to do it this way. You could just do the gorgeous grape layer and use the templates. I'm not going to tell you the measurements because it's different in every country and I don't want to confuse you. So if you get our card templates, not only will you get it in your country size, but you will also be able to get, say if you live in Australia and you use metric, A4 metric, and then if you get imperial inches, then you can do a conversion. I know. So if you're watching someone in the US and you're like, oh, they said that they use this inch and this inch. Well, you can use our card template tutorial to figure out what that means in A4 metric. Mind blown. Yes, I know. It's like, can you believe it? I cannot believe it. Now, we're going to chop this at our Poppy Parade size. So if you have your card templates there again, chop Poppy Parade. And actually, probably a recommendation I like to do with the basic white is just to score first. It just has a much nicer cut. I don't know why, it just gives it a little groove to go into and it cuts it really nicely. Now, our next layer is actually going to be the Bubble Bath, but what I'm going to do is cut it at Poppy Parade as well, even though we need melon mambo size. And the reason for that is just to give a little bit of extra room for the embossing folder, because usually when we emboss, we lose a little bit on each edge. And it's usually only one side too, which is really random, but we want it to be lined up really nicely. Now, I've got three embossing folders here that I wanted to show you from the new mini catalog, and they are just incredible. They're huge, which I absolutely adore, because the usual size for Australians, we've got a skinny and tall card. It's very different in the US. It's wide and short in the US. And we find a lot of the standard embossing folders, just we can't get it edge to edge, and it just doesn't work well for us. So I'm loving that Stampin' Up! Are bringing out these embossing folders that are a little bit bigger, great for scrapbookers as well. So if you've been like, why would they do this? Please think of everyone outside of the US and Canada, because we don't have the same size card as you. And we are loving these sizes. So please keep them going, Stampin' Up. There is also the Birchwood 3D. And there's also the Painted Trees, which is absolutely gorgeous. And these are three brand new embossing folders from the mini catalog. So if you haven't got those, definitely add them, because it's a little bit difficult to see them in the catalog and you may have missed them. But they are really, really brilliant embossing folders. And I love to have the whole set of embossing folders, because the minute I decide, you know what, I'm going to use that embossing folder, I want it to be there. I want to have it on hand, ready for me to use. And I don't want to wait. I don't want to wait to order it and have to sit around waiting to do my project because I want to use that embossing folder. I'm like, nope, I want it right now. So order it right now and then it'll be there when you want to use it, which is great. So we're going to use the 3D. Now the 3D embossing sandwich is actually plate number one and plate number four. I just grabbed that one off the table. So plate number four as well. And it tells you that on the instructions here. You can see one and four. It'll tell you. So if you're wondering, did I just make that up? No, it's written there on the front. We just have to take the time to read. And it is not my strong point, but I do my best. I'll read for you. I'll tell you what it is. So there we go. That's all happy. And we'll put our skim back again. Stamp and Cut in a Boss Machine. So this is Forever Plaid. Amazing. How gorgeous is that? I just think it's going to look so good. And I love that the lines are sort of like a little bit hand-drawn look. And you can use both sides. So whatever you prefer. I really like this one. But yeah, both work. They're amazing. Now, let's see if this, because the next layer that we wanted to cut was Melon Mambo. And we'll just see if we need to trim any of this off. Because we did it a little bit larger, I'm just scoring it first. We really want to get in there before we chop. Very good. And then the other side, we want to do, what's the other size for Melon Mambo? I should know it off by heart by now, but sometimes I don't trust my brain. My brain is not always my friend. Burnish, 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 score, 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 and cut. So you can see here, this was definitely a lot smaller than this one. So lengthways, it was just that little bit, and you can see it would have been just a little bit out if we had have cut it to size. It would have squished the cardstock, which makes sense because you're putting all these indentations. So I was going to change the size of that card, and we want it to fit perfectly within that size there that we've made, because it's just so, look at that, it's like a little whisker of basic white, and if I went over, then it just wouldn't have sat as nice as I wanted it to. You can see it better when I put it onto the card here. It's just so close to the edge that you just want that to be really accurate. Good. Now, our next layers that we're going to be using is these three layers here. So you can see we've got the basic white, we've got the Highland Heather, and then the cardstock piece. Now, let's have a little look here. I want to make sure that I've got the right layers because I actually only pulled out two layers when I actually need three. But I know what the third layer will be. I'm pretty sure it will be the Highland Heather. So let's have a little look here. Oh no, it's not that one. I lied, everyone. Don't believe a word that I've said. Fresh Freesia, of course. So we've got these three layers here. Yes. So we've got Balmy Blue layer. And remember, these are not the colours I'm using. These are my measurements. Knight of Navy and Fresh Freesia. And if you don't have our card templates, you won't understand what I'm talking about. So purchase the tutorial. You will then understand what on earth I'm talking about. And you're just going to love it. You will not regret having my tutorial. So Balmy Blue is our first layer. Let's cut that one to size. And what I love about having these is you can actually see here, this is not going to cut well this way. So I know I have to cut it this way in order for this to fit. I always used to find it difficult to know, am I getting the most out of my cardstock? Am I cutting it the best possible way to get the most out of it? And this just tells you straight away, you're like, well, I can't cut it that way because it's too long. So it needs to be cut this way. I just found that for me, that was probably one of the most difficult things I would get stuck with when I was crafting, was my measurements. Me and math are not friends. We do not get along. We do not like each other. So we've found a way to compromise. We've found a way to be friends. I have demystified math in my brain. So that is layer one. Now, layer two, we want to be in the Highland Heather. So we have some of that here. I'm like, where did it go? Here we go. This is the Highland Heather. Now, that is going to be the Knight of Navy size. So let's chop that down. Now, again, you can use your Knight of Navy. You can see here it's not going to cut this way. So we have to cut it this way. So then you know, oh, okay, if I'm cutting it this way, I know exactly which way I need to cut. It's just, it helps my, I don't know why, it just helps my brain. And hopefully all of you are the same. It's like, I don't know. It just works for me. Some people like Rachel Tessman just have maths brains and they just get it and they just know what they're doing. I am not one of those people, and that's okay. I have found a way to help us all. And the last layer is the Fresh Freesia, and this is what we're going to cut the paper out of. So I'm just going to go right to that corner because I think that that will have nice amount of sky, a beautiful, I don't want to have this beautiful pathway. It's just a really nice piece there, but you could even do it again and have this beautiful piece here. It's just going to look so pretty no matter where you put it along this edge here. So we need to chop the best way to chop this, let's have a little look here so that we can get the most out of this paper. So I think the best way to chop would be chopping it this way. So then all you're going to have left over is just a little bit of sky. But if you were to chop this way, suddenly you're restricting, like you're cutting all the sky off, and you may want to use this piece as like a poppy parade size, like a full card front or something like that later on. So you can see here, it's not gonna quite fit for poppy parade, but you could grab the templates and have a little look here. Maybe the Flirty Flamingo might fit. No, it's still a little bit big. Maybe Granny Apple. Yes, that fits. So you can even go Granny Apple, or even like the one that's a little bit bigger than Granny Apple Green, which I think could be our Daffodil Delight. There you go. So you can get a layer out of that. If you chopped your paper all the way across at the Fresh Freesia, you're now limiting your options to have the Daffodil Delight layer. Does that make sense? So that's where I like to sort of gauge what's the best way for me to cut this so that I'm left with the best piece of paper that I can use later. Some of you like to chop it down to the Poppy Parade size, and that still works. Like, it still fits for that. But if you wanted to, that's just an option if you keep it at the 6x6. So let's chop that down. We need that one there. There we go. I've got my trusty glasses on today to help me. But they're my multifocals, and I find I have to lift my head nice and high to get the reading bit. Okay, let's have a look at how this looks and see if I've picked the right colors for this layer. Oh, I really like that. I think it's really brought out some beautiful colors in this background here. It's just really making it all pop. And I love that even though this is an autumnal style card, I love that you can use other colors with it. Like, don't think it has to be the same as the catalog and the same colors in here. We've really changed up. We've used none of the colors in here. And I wanted to show you that so that you can see that you don't have to stick with what Stampin' Up! Has used. And it also will help you to see these beautiful papers in a different way as well. You might be like, oh, I didn't really like the autumnal colors, but I'm very much for the summer or winter colors. And yeah, this has sold me now. I am not a pink girl and I am not a purple girl. But I really know a lot of you are. I'm talking to you, Megan Laquanu. She's like, secretly, I think you really are. I think you really do love. You do love pink. No, I promise I don't. Now, I felt like that this one was cut a little bit too big. Yes, I did. I was like, why is that not matching up properly? And it's because I didn't look at my card template properly. So isn't it cool? I don't have to guess. My card template tells me, it spits it out and says, here you go. And I know I can have confidence that all these layers here, and they're small little layers, but they're going to look so good all together. The card template tutorial just makes me look like a professional. So all of those line up so well. And then they're going to sit on top here. Now, we've also got the sentiment that we want to use, and that's using the Autumn Expressions stamp set. This is a beautiful, beautiful sentiment stamp set. You want this in your repertoire, I should say, because it's just classic fonts, classic sentiments, and they're just really, really beautiful. I'm going to use the Grateful For You because, you know, we are grateful to our beautiful customers for all that they do. And that's going to sit really nicely over that piece there. Now, we're going to do that in the Highland Heather and emboss. So let's do that. Sorry if that makes a loud noise on the camera. We've got our Versamark, and I've got all of my embossing tools here. So I've got my white emboss. We just need a block to pop this on. Of course, in true Kylie style, we have a messy block. Look away, all my friends that like everything tidy, tidy. I'm not your gal. I'm a tiny person, I'm just a bit disorganized. Disorganization is my thing. And I own it and I love it. It's who I am. It makes me creative. I figure you can't have it all, right? Well, some people do. Good for them. I'm really happy for you. Oh, look how beautiful that is. That Wow Emboss Powder. Wow, wow, wow. Love, love, love. We cannot talk more highly of it. Just trashed a bit on the table there. Whoopsie. It's all right. It's very minimal. Goodbye. Goodbye embossing powder. I didn't want like little bits of pieces in there. It wasn't worth saving those few grains of embossing powder. Okay, so let's emboss this one. Now with these lighter colours, if you wanted to, you can always do a little bit of sponging with them as well afterwards. And it's really going to help that sentiment to pop off the page a little bit more. Because especially doing white emboss on a lighter colour, you know, sometimes it can be a little bit insipid. But I actually don't mind the look of this on here. I think it pops quite nicely, which is very surprising. Surprise, surprise. Oh, gorgeous. Now I'll get my fancy snips. They're the one with the ribbon on it, because I know that they cut the best, although I am due for new. I like to treat myself every 6 months or so, I think. I think that's a good estimate with the amount of cards that I make. Okay, and I do a lot of snipping. I really enjoy snipping. So it all depends on how often you snip. So I'm just moving my cardstock to the left. And I don't have to go too far in. Like here, down here, I don't have to go too far. But I'll go a little bit closer to these ones. I'm just going to chop this out just so that I've got a little bit less paper to deal with. Because I do find it a little bit easier when the surface area is a bit smaller. There we go. And hello to all our latecomers. I know there's a few of you that usually jump on and go, sorry, I'm late. And we go, don't worry, as long as you're here, we're happy to have you here. So there's always something that's going on in life, right? Or we forget. We're like, oh my goodness, that's right, Kylie's gone live. Oh, gorgeous. I really love that. So let's have a look at that. Yeah, I think that's perfect. But what I would like to do, let's just mix things up here a little bit. Because I really love this tree here, let's just see what it looks like doing it on the other side. Ooh, or maybe even up there. Let's have a look at on that side. I do like it being left. I don't know what I like about it being left justification. Yeah, I think that's what we're going to do. We're going to come up here a little bit, I think. Anyway, we'll stick it all down and then we'll know what we like. We'll compare the pair. So let's do all our sticking. We've got our bubble bath that we need to stick. There we go. So we need that even closer. This is why I like my Tombow glue, for very tight places like this. Oop. I just moved it and then it got stuck. Yeah, when it's really, really close like this, the Tombow glue is my bestest friend because it helps me to make sure that I've got it in the right spot. That's great. Yes, yes, yes. And then we'll stick this down here. Now, instead of doing this embossing folder, you could always stamp this background, you know, use some stamps just to create a little bit of texture in the background. You could use designer series paper here, so one of the textured pieces, so like the back here, you could use one of those pieces, depending on which one you like. So there's a lot of options. Once you've got the layers, you can sort of pick and choose what you want that background piece to be. Now we'll put our beautiful piece of paper that looks like a piece of art, doesn't it? So framing it like this, I just think is so nice. And not having to use the whole sheet too. We're like framing just a special part of the paper, but we still have more there that we can use. Go. Oh, got stuck to me. And a bit of basic white layer. Wonderful. Isn't that gorgeous? Oh my goodness. I am in love. Now we're going to raise that up on dimensionals. And I think I've got my, yes, there they are. Oh no, they're the minis. Oh, here are the normal size. So I like to put them in a case here so that they're ready to go. And I've got pieces that I've cut out too if I wanted to use those. Now, I use a lot of dimensionals. Don't sue me for it, but I don't like saggy bums on myself and on my cards. So I like it to be nicely, you know, looked after. Because if I leave too big a gap, I'm going to get a saggy bit. And I don't like saggy bits on my cards. So I figure I've gone to all this trouble of making a beautiful card. I may as well do it professionally. Do it nicely, hey? Now let's figure out where we want this sentiment. I actually feel like, yeah, we could even go lower, but I think I feel like a good spot is sort of, I want that tree to sort of still poke out. So maybe it is okay in that little spot there. Because that one is actually very nice as well. Because it's highlighting that beautiful pathway. Yeah, I think maybe something like that. Where it's sort of sitting partially off. Yeah, I like that. And then there's also here where we've got the tree sort of still poking out both sides. That's actually quite nice as well. So totally up to you. If you don't like it covering so much of the tree, you could use a smaller sentiment so that it's not covering as much, because you can see the grateful for you is quite large, but the change can be beautiful is quite good. But even these other ones here, they're really tiny, and then they're going to really like not cover too much of that. You can see here the change is beautiful, is sort of longer and thinner. Another idea that you could do is, oh, there goes the stamp set, is to cut out the pieces individually, and then you could even lengthen it then, like to have grateful for you, and you could have that in a different spot. So totally up to you what you want to do with that. But I'm going to stick that down directly onto that paper there. And we're just doing one half because the other half is sort of going to be sitting in limbo. We want that L to be off the edge, not sticking over. Beautiful. Love it. Chop it. Now, we need some embellishments. The normal one that goes with this suite of products is called the Faux Glass Dots, or as Bruno likes to say, the Faux Glass Dots, because that's what Bruno does. He loves to have fun with words. And everyone thinks he's serious. And I'm like, they think you're serious. They think you think it's vellum, and it's not. And he's like, I don't care, whatever. So I thought that these purple fine shimmer gems were a winner. I really love these, and I think that they just bring out those colours really nicely. I'm going to go for this one up the top, but even these ones here would actually be quite nice. And yeah, even them, whatever you prefer. But yes, I'm going to go for these ones here. So we can just use our little gluey take your pick tool end. And as most of you know, I like to do three. And I love to do the larger one and then the smaller one underneath. That's my usual go-to. But, you know, I've seen people not do three. I've seen people do even numbers, but I'm very much like an odd. And usually it's three or five. That's my usual go-to. So, and I like two together and then one on its own. And I love it when it, like, it hugs the sentiment. If you wanted to, you could even, like, we can even lift this up a little bit. And you'll see here, even though I've positioned it, I'm able to move it. It's just the type of glue. If you know how to lift it up, you could even use the little spade. This one here. Where is it? Which end? I think it's this one here. Nope. Maybe I don't have that one with me. Ooh, maybe it's this end. I don't think it is, though. I love having all these. No, that's the hook. I'm not sure where the spade one is. No, can't see it. It's disappeared. Of course it's gone walk about. Of course. Why didn't I think of that? But yes, there is another one that has a spade end, and it's very handy for, look, yeah, I'm looking, everyone. It's all right. Stop looking. I've given up already. But yes, that will help you to lift it up. But I do like it sitting on top of here. I think it just sort of disappeared over there. You could even use this over on this edge here so that you can still see it. But I just feel like that space there is not large enough. So yeah, my go-to would definitely be over this side here, sort of next to the sentiment, really showing and highlighting those beautiful gems, because I don't want them to be hidden. I want them to have the hero. They want to be the hero of the story, because even this one here, you can see it's sort of, it's there, but it's, yeah, you can see that a lot better, that one. It's, yeah, a bit more striking. Now, the last thing to do is our inside. So let's do our Poppy Parade layer for the inside. I always like to do Poppy Parade, but you don't have to. You could do smaller. You could do a piece of DSP and then do a smaller one. It's really amazing what you could do on the inside. But I do like an inside. If I send that now, just as it is, or I write on here, I just feel like it's a bit nudie broody. It's being a bit rude. It's just exposing itself. I just feel like it's not completely finished unless it's got an insert. And you don't have to, but we've got lots of paper there to use, so why not have some paper? Right? Why not? You know, you've got so much in your cupboard. Just use it. Why not? You've got this beautiful card. Just go to town with it, right? Take it to town. Look at that. Look at that beautiful piece that we can have just a strip along there. So we'll cut the strip, and it's just like, you know, 1 centimeter or something like that, which is what, 1/4 of an inch? Doesn't have to be much. And then you just cut it to the Poppy Parade size so that it's, you know, edge to edge. Again, you saw me just score that first. I just find it doesn't grab as badly as when I don't do it. Because I've had some paper like almost like scrunch up. And I'm like, why have you gone all scrunchy? So I like a little bit of a border there. Just to highlight that beautiful paper. Isn't that gorgeous? Look at that. And it just naturally goes with that paper. And then if you want to step it up even further, because as I said, you've got plenty of paper there, so don't be frugal, okay? Don't hold back. You've got all this amazing, amazing, amazing paper, so use it. Kylie has given you permission. And once you use it, guess what, peeps? I also give you permission to buy more. Yes, we can go shopping, and we all want an excuse to go shopping, right? So the best excuse to go shopping is when you use it. You're like, yes, I deserve it. I've worked hard. I've put 3 pieces of paper on my card today, so I can get more paper. I really like that paper, so I'm going to get more. Do you like that? Do you like that reasoning? It's called girl math. You're welcome. I'm glad I could assist you. It's called How to Shop Guilt-Free. I made a card and it had paper on the inside. I'm going to treat myself. Oh, look at that. Gorgeous. Who wouldn't want it on the inside as well? It's so pretty. It makes me want to cry. And I really don't like pink, but I do like pink today. So there you go, lovely people. What do you think? Do you like my customer cards for this month? I really, really like them. And of course, there's going to be completely different colors, different embossing embossing folders, because we're going to have, you know, autumnal type colors with Cajun Crays, and it's just going to be such a variety of beautiful cards this month. So if you would like a little surprise in the mail, and we all like surprise mail, then these customer cards are definitely what you're wanting. You just have to place an order with us, KylieBertucci.com, and click on the Shop Now button. Let me show you exactly how to do that, because, you know, why not? Why not make it easier for you all to go shopping? Remember, if you use paper on the inside, you're allowed to. So this is my website here, KylieBertucci.com, and all you need to do is just click on the Shop button, and you can click on that actual button or go to our Stampin' Up! Store, and that will open up like so. Ta-da! Oops, we don't want that one. That's when it's joined. I'm like, oh no, we don't want you seeing my stats. But yes, that is the store. Let me just log out so I can show you something on the store, because, you know, it's fun to see the store. And the cool thing is at the moment is that there is a special. So that is very, very exciting. A starter kit special. And I'm going to tell you about that, because it's just so awesome to have a starter kit special. Don't we love it? Yes, we do. We always love to have a special. So this is what you can see when you come on here. So this is the starter kit special here that I wanted to show you, plus the clearance rack too. Check that out, because we always love a bit of a deal. But this one here is amazing, to get $286 worth of products for only $169. Yes, please. We want that now, Stampin' Up! So it's just really brilliant to be part of this amazing community of stampers. And once you join up, you get 20% discount, or if you sell something, 20% commission on everything that you either buy or sell, which is wonderful. And it's minimum, like that can increase depending on how much you buy or how much you sell. So there's some really great incentives. It's really important to choose a team leader that you know you're going to connect with. We would love to be that team leader for you. But if you like in-person events, then we are not the person for you, because we are all online. So just please really do your due diligence, question who you're thinking about joining with, particularly if you're wanting to establish a business. It's really important that you get the right demonstrator to join with, because it does make a big difference long term in terms of what support and training and everything that you get. So yeah, there's some frequently asked questions there. If you've got, you know, a bit of concern or anything like that, it's all there for you. So we would love to invite you. And if you have any questions, please don't hesitate to reach out to us. But it's a brilliant deal at the moment. To get $286 worth of product and you only pay $169. So let's have a look here. Let me do the math for you. That is $117 of product for free. And you can pick anything you want in your starter kit. You're not set. It's not a kit that you have to get. You can pick $286 of any product you like, including the clearance rack, including brand new product that only demonstrators can get. Yes, please. And you get free postage on top of that as well. So it's a really great deal at the moment. Anything else that I need to show you? Any other show and tells that I need to give you? There was one thing here I wanted to let you know, actually. That is our beautiful online stamping retreat. Oh my goodness, it was so much fun. Thank you so much to everyone that came last Sunday, Saturday in the US. Thank you so, so much. It was an amazing event. So successful. There was one point where Bruno and I thought our internet was going to crash, but it came back, thank goodness. We were so stressed, but it went so well. And we have opened all of our previous online stamping retreats. If you scan the QR code there, right there, that QR code right there. If you scan that, it will take you to all of our retreats where you can purchase any of the previous events. But that is for a very, very, very limited time. And we have had people ask us in between, and you're going to have to wait until next year to be able to do that, to be able to purchase past events. So please do it now if you would like to get this amazing bundle of classes, the videos, unlimited access, plus a 231-page tutorial, 32 Funfold projects. Like, this is a resource that you are going to go back to time and time again. All the previous events, I still go back to them. I'm always looking for ideas. I'm like, I'm just going to have a look for a Funfold card idea. Boom. There's always something there for me. So it's a brilliant resource to go back to time and time again. So please check that out. Scan that QR code, or you can go to onlinestampingretreat.com. And that will take you to our retreats. So definitely check that out. And if you're someone who loves autumn and autumnal colors, just a reminder that Bruno and I came up with this beautiful Changing Seasons bundle. This is a project that we did ourselves. It's 6 projects, and you will absolutely love this. This is such a gorgeous product that you can get. It's a tutorial. There's no video, so please keep that in mind, that it's just a tutorial only. But it is so fantastic. We know that so many people absolutely adored it. And it is $10 Australian. What's that in the US? Probably $1.50. No, I'm kidding. Probably about $5. It's a bargain. So keep that in mind. It's a lot cheaper for everyone else in the world. $10 in Australia, but very cheap everywhere else. So you're going to love the designs in there. Really great techniques and a lot to learn from those amazing projects. So lots to do. I'm very excited that we can give you lots of support and lots of ideas, just so that you can use all of your beautiful products. That Changing Leaves bundle is absolutely stunning. It's an online exclusive, and who knows, it may be going soon. So if you like it, go and get it. That's what I always say about the online exclusives. Get them straight away. If you know you like it, get them before they go. So thank you all for being here. Big hugs to you all. We really appreciate you all being here, and we love you very, very much. And please know we're thinking of you all, and that we're constantly just overwhelmed by your love and kindness, and just the way that you look after one another in our beautiful community. We really, really love our community, and we shall see you next week for another amazing video of some sort. Look out for what's coming up, and I know that you're going to love it. So we'll see you then, everyone. Bye for now. I miss you already. Don't go. Bye.